Welcome students and teachers. Today's topic is distances, how we measure distances in astronomical scales when objects are in space. It's a very simple topic in theory, but it's quite challenging. For centuries, astronomers have been trying to refine various methods, but even with the modern equipments and these tools, it is still quite challenging to understand the vastness of universe and underlying physics. In this video, we will talk about few basic terms and some basic methods. So let's dive in. So one of the early astronomical distance term that you might have heard is AU, one AU, astronomical unit. Previously, it was defined as average of aphelion and perihelion, which is the closest distance from Earth to Sun to farthest distance from Earth to Sun. So average will be the semi-major axis of the elliptical orbit. But it has a problem with it that this closest point and farthest point often change. So for consistency, in 2012, International Astronomical Union redefined this term to be exactly this number, this 149 billion something meter. So that all the measurements and recordings are consistent. So, but how we came up with this number, what's the importance of AU historically, why it was being used, is a topic for another day. But whenever we talk about distances in solar system scale, other than Earth-Moon distance, almost all the distances, let's say Jupiter is roughly 5 AU from the Sun. So this is how we report or tell what the distances are. Now, if we want to measure or report distances outside solar system scale, we use a term called light year. What is a light year? So that it is the distance light travels in a vacuum in exactly 365.25 days. This is how it is defined in modern days. And also, despite of its misleading term, light year is a measure of distance. It is not a measure of time. So we know speed of light, roughly 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. We know exactly the time we are interested in, so we can calculate. So speed of light is known very precisely, time is known very precisely, so light year is also defined to a very significant extent. However, in this problem, we have purposefully made use of significant digits, since the least significant number in this calculation is speed of light. We have purposefully approximated it to only one significant digit. So the final answer should also be in one significant digit. It's not very helpful to remember the light year for exactly 16 significant digits. It's often helpful to have an order of magnitude idea. And also it's not often very required in astronomical calculations. So typically this is used for galactic measurements. So if you want within a galaxy scale, nearby stars or size of galaxies, light year is a pretty handy unit. Mostly it was used because distances were so large, kilometers and meters were not making that much useful sense. So light year unit was introduced. Right, so as I already mentioned, when we talk about solar system scale, we use astronomical unit. When we go slightly farther away, light year, nearby stars. If we say, for example, distance between Sun and nearby galaxies, we use a term called parsec or kiloparsec. And what is this term? So for that, we have to understand that what is parallax. So if you have traveled on a road, train, or some other means, what you might have noticed that the nearby objects, they cross you at relatively high angular speed. And the very farther distant object, mountains, maybe Sun, Moon, they appear to be very stationary. And this is the important useful fact that we use for using parallax. Depending on how quickly the angular displacement is relative to your shift in viewpoint, you can estimate how far the objects are. So for example, in this video, because some of the cactuses, plants are moving quite fast, in terms of angular displacement, you know they are nearby. And the mountains and other distant objects who are practically stationary, you know that they are far away. And this concept is often used. So what you can think about if there are, let's say, two observers at two different cities, and both of them are observing the same asteroid solar system body, both of them will see this asteroid slightly different in relation to the distant star. So as I already mentioned, distant objects practically don't move. So this asteroid will appear to be have in a different sky position for two different observers. So if we measure how much it has shifted, we can, and we know the distance between these two cities, we know roughly how far that object has to be. Now, question for you is, what is the maximum distance these two observers can have to measure a parallax? One obvious answer would be the diameter of Earth, but if you think about it, it will be the diametrical opposite position in the orbit of Earth around the Sun. We are assuming it to be roughly circular. So we know this distance to be roughly 2 astronomical unit, and if we could measure how this star, relatively nearby star, is moving compared to the background distant stars, this angle is what we are interested in. This is called parallax angle. So in this triangle, for example, this is 1 astronomical unit, this is known. This angle we can calculate, and we can get from trigonometry this distance. This is slightly misleading diagram in a sense. It may appear that for this technique to hold, star has to be in the plane or maybe perpendicular to the plane, but it's not actually required. Star could be in any orientation in the sky, and this triangular formula will still hold. So what we notice, let's call the Sun as point S. So angle S A E prime in this diagram, this is the angle parallax that we are interested in measuring, and we can measure the shift in star's position. So this tan of angle S A E prime will be the distance between Sun Earth, which is 1 AU, which we know, divided by the distance. Since these distances are quite large, we can use some approximation. So we know tan X equals to X when X is very small, but for that X has to be in radians. So we consider what happens if that angular shift is about 1 arc second, that is about 1 by 3600 degree. So that will be, this tan of this quantity will be 1 arc second, but in radians. Okay, and this we know approximately is 1 AU divided by the distance to the star. Rearranging this equation, we get distance as 1 AU divided by 1 arc second in radians. So this much degree times conversion from degree to radians, we get this quantity. Roughly what we get, if we simplify, this distance when parallax is 1 arc second is around 200,000 AU, roughly. This is a nice useful number to remember, 206265. So if 1 arc second is the parallax, this many AU, or this much, 3 in 10 to power 16 meter roughly, is what the distance would be. You can think it of as 3.26 light year. And this is also a reason why we require such units, because numbers can be quite large. All right, so now we know this methodology. I also would like to point out that when Earth rotates around the Sun in roughly, say, the circular orbit, depending on where the star is, if it's exactly overhead to the orbit, perpendicular to the orbit, or within the plane of orbit, or somewhere else, the star will appear to follow an ellipse. Sometimes circles, when it is in the same plane, it will appear to move in a line. This elliptical motion, apparent motion, also sometimes help us to understand what, how far this is. Obviously, we, if there are multiple stars that are nearby, you will see different stars to have different ellipses as well. Okay. So just for clarification, all of the time these diagrams are not to scale, and also they are sometimes misleading. It's also not necessary that the Earth has to be diametrically opposite in the orbit, because we know what these ellipses are. There are modern methods where you can find what this apparent shift is. As long as we have this information, we have half of this angular displacement, we can calculate what the distance is. All right, so Let's consider parallax measured by New Horizon, a space probe launched to study Pluto. So it's at quite a distance from Earth now. So when it was around 46, 47 astronomical unit away from the Sun, what it measured, it photographed Proxima Centauri, which is closest star to the Sun. At roughly the same time, one of the observatory in Australia also photographed Proxima Centauri. And what we see in these two images, one taken by New Horizon, one taken on Earth, we see this star appears to move. And the rest of the stars, because they are relatively much distant, they don't move much. So with this shift, you can actually calculate, if you know this distance, you can calculate how far this has to be. You can also calculate if parallax measured on Earth is given, what will be the parallax that New Horizon will measure, how much shift this will be. Right, so now we have developed this method to calculate roughly how far stars are. Let's look at some of the typical numbers. Alpha Centauri or Proxima Centauri is about 4.25 light year. It's in constellation Centaurus. Barnard star, another important star that is relatively near to us, is around 6 light years. So these are the scales typically that we see. Sirius, one of the brightest night sky star, is again 8.7 light years. So around 20, 300, 500. These are the ranges that you see stars when you look at the night sky. These are the distance that they are at, and still bright enough for us to see them. So as you see, as distances increase, the parallax angle will become smaller and smaller, and that will cause a challenge because instruments have to be really sensitive to measure those angle. And typically when stars are pretty far away, order of 1000 light years or more, some of the measuring instruments fail to detect the parallax angle, and we have to rely on certain other techniques, which we will discuss in later videos. Alright, so now coming to galactic scale, the typical stars that we talked about in the previous slide, all of them or most of the stars that you see in your night sky, roughly all of them are within the circle shown. This is roughly the position of Sun in relation to Milky Way galaxy. As you can already see, Milky Way galaxy is quite large relative to what stars we see. So if you would like to know what these typical numbers and dimensions are, distance from the Sun to the center of Milky Way galaxy is around 8,000 parsec, or we can say 8 kiloparsec. Similarly, diameter is about 27-30-ish kiloparsec. Rough diameter of Milky Way galaxy is around 27-30-ish kiloparsec. In relation to its diameter, the thickness of Milky Way galaxy is quite less. The smallest region is roughly around 1000 light years. There is a bulge in the center, and the disk is not uniform, so it varies, but it's a useful sum of the numbers to know what typical dimensions are. I will end with one of another useful quantity, that distance between Milky Way galaxy and nearby large galaxy Andromeda is around 2.5 million light year, or 760 kiloparsec. When we talk about distances at these scales, we can't actually use parallax. We have to use different methods, topic for another video maybe. So distance is quite useful parameters in astronomy. Why? Because if we want to measure how bright a star is or an object is. So that's all on this topic. If you have any doubts, any questions, do let us know. And yeah, thank you.